Chapter 15. After some days at the time of wheat harvest, Samson went to visit his wife with a young goat, and he said, I will go into my wife in the chamber. But her father would not allow him to go in. And her father said, I really thought that you utterly hated her, so I gave her to your companion. Is not her younger sister more beautiful than she? Please take her instead. And Samson said to them, This time I shall be innocent in regard to the Philistines when I do them harm. So Samson went and caught 300 foxes and took torches. And he turned them tail to tail, and put a torch between each pair of tails. And when he had set fire to the torches, he let the foxes go into the standing grain of the Philistines, and set fire to the stacked grain and the standing grain, as well as the olive orchards. Then the Philistines said, Who has done this? And they said, Samson, the son-in-law of the Timnite, because he has taken his wife and given her to his companion. And the Philistines came up and burned her and her father with fire. And Samson said to them, If this is what you do, I swear I will be avenged on you, and after that I will quit. And he struck them hip and thigh with a great blow, and he went down and stayed in the cleft of the rock of Edom. Then the Philistines came up and encamped in Judah and made a raid on Lehi. And the men of Judah said, Why have you come up against us? They said, We have come up to bind Samson, to do to him as he did to us. Then 3,000 men of Judah went down to the cleft of the rock of Edom and said to Samson, Do you not know that the Philistines are rulers over us? What then is this that you have done to us? And he said to them, As they did to me, so have I done to them. And they said to him, We have come down to bind you, that we may give you into the hands of the Philistines. And Samson said to them, Swear to me that you will not attack me yourselves. They said to him, No, we will only bind you and give you into their hands. We will surely not kill you. So they bound him with 2 new ropes and brought him up from the rock. When he came to Lehi, the Philistines came shouting to meet him. Then the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon him, and the ropes that were on his arms became as flax that has caught fire, and his bonds melted off his hands. And he found a fresh jawbone of a donkey, and put out his hand and took it, and with it he struck 1,000 men. And Samson said, With the jawbone of a donkey, heaps upon heaps, with the jawbone of a donkey have I struck down 1,000 men. As soon as he had finished speaking, he threw away the jawbone out of his hand. And that place was called Ramath-Lehi. And he was very thirsty, and he called upon the Lord and said, You have granted this great salvation by the hand of your servant. And shall I now die of thirst and fall into the hands of the uncircumcised? And God split open the hollow place that is at Lehi, and water came out from it. And when he drank, his spirit returned, and he revived. Therefore the name of it was called En-Hakkari. It is at Lehi to this day. And he judged Israel in the days of the Philistines 20 years. There came to him some Sadducees, those who deny that there is a resurrection, and they asked him a question, saying, Teacher, Moses wrote for us that if a man's brother dies, having a wife but no children, the man must take the widow and raise up offspring for his brother. Now there were 7 brothers. The first took a wife and died without children, and the second and the third took her, and likewise all 7 left no children and died. Afterward the woman also died. In the resurrection, therefore, whose wife will the woman be? For the 7 had her as wife. And Jesus said to them, The sons of this age marry and are given in marriage, but those who are considered worthy to attain to that age and to the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage, for they cannot die any more, because they are equal to angels and are sons of God, being sons of the resurrection. But that the dead are raised, even Moses showed, in the passage about the bush, where he calls the Lord the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. Now he is not God of the dead, but of the living, for all live to him. Then some of the scribes answered, Teacher, you have spoken well. For they no longer dared to ask him any question.
Hello and welcome to Bible Time. Today, Judges chapter 15. Samson got married to a Philistine woman, only to find out at the end of his wedding, the father of the bride gave her to the best man. Later on, Samson visited to see his wife. His father-in-law refused to take Samson to meet her. Infuriated, Samson went out and caught 300 foxes and put the fire on their tails and released the fox. And the fox went all around the field, burning the crops of Philistine. And the Philistine attacked the man of Judah in Lehi. So the people of Judah took Samson and bind him to deliver him to Philistine. When he was delivered to the Philistine, the Spirit of the Lord rushed upon Samson, and the rope caught on fire. setting Samson free. Samson took a jawbone of a donkey and struck 1,000 Philistine men. And Samson judged Israel in the days of Philistine for 20 years. And now Luke chapter 20, verse 27 through 40, the religious leader continues to trap Jesus at his word. So a group of men, Sadducees, asked about the issues on marriage. They ask if a woman remarries in heaven, which man does the woman belongs to? Jesus answered that there is no marriage in heaven, and people are going to be just like same level as the angels. So in heaven, we will not define in human relationship. We will not be related as father or mother or grandpa or husband or sons or daughters. In heaven, we will all be individual, just people, just be all children of God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We know that we will all be the children of God in heaven. Everyone will be just individuals. We will just love one another and love you as your child. So Father, I pray that you will help us to really sink that into our mind. In Jesus' name, amen.